AWS has 15 years of experience enabling customers to unlock the value from their data at scale. We do this by providing customers with all the required tools across their data journey. Each year during reInvent, we announce a lot of new services and feature launches. And these services and feature launches were built on the direct feedback from customers like you. And this year, there was no difference. Hello, everyone. This is Navneet Shukla. I'm a senior solution architect specializing in analytics. In the next 15 minutes, we are going to learn about all the exciting announcement which was made during the reInvent 2022 for the builders. Let's start with Amazon Redshift. Builders love Redshift because it's allowed them to break down their data silos and offer up to 5x better price performance at any scale. The beauty of Redshift, it allows you to analyze all your data, whether it's in your data warehouse, in your data lake using features like Redshift Spectrum and through federated query feature, even from your operational databases. It's super easy to use and very secure and reliable. At reInvent, we had a ton of announcements around Redshift. Let's begin with support for autocopy from Amazon S3. The autocopy feature in Amazon Redshift simplifies automatic data loading from Amazon S3 with a simple SQL command. You can enable Amazon Redshift autocopy by creating jobs. Autocopy comes with many benefits, such as SQL user like data analysts can now load data from Amazon S3 automatically without having to build a custom pipeline or using an external framework. Copy jobs offer continuous and incremental data ingestions from an Amazon S3 location without the need to implement a custom solution. Existing copy statement can also be converted into copy job by appending the job create job name parameter. It keeps track of all the loaded files and prevent data duplication. It can easily set up using SQL statement and any JDBC or ODBC client. At the end, this functionality comes at no additional cost. Now let's learn how this autocopy jobs work. You can extract the data from external data sources and have it stored in Amazon S3. Once the data in Amazon S3, autocopy jobs start picking your data and perform the data ingestion in your table. You can have one or many jobs writing to your tables. Here's the syntax of autocopy. So in autocopy, you will be creating a job by providing the job name and parameters, which is auto on and off, which let you do an incremental data load. And it avoid having the data duplication because it will be not doing and ingesting the same file again. Error handling and monitoring of a copy jobs. Redshift offers many systems tables for you to list on your copy jobs, such as SysCopy Jobs allow you to list your copy jobs. You can get the summary of a copy job using the Sys load history. You can get the detail of your copy job using the STL load commit. And you can get the exception of your copy jobs, or you're able to see the errors using the STL load error. The next in line is now Amazon Redshift supports dynamic data masking. So dynamic data masking made customer protect sensitive data by managing data masking policies through a SQL interface. Customer can modify sensitive or PII data based on the role-based access control. Masking can be full or partial mask based on the requirements, whether masking can be applied to the shell label based on the specific condition. With the data masking support, which is in preview, you can do the following. Define masking policies that can apply custom obfuscation policies. For example, masking policies to handle credit card, PII entities, HIPAA or GDPR's need, etc. Transform the data at query time to apply masking policy. Attach masking policies to role or user. Attach multi-masking policies with varying level of obfuscations to the same column in the table and assign them to different roles with the priorities to avoid conflicts. implement cell label masking by using conditions columns when they're creating your masking policy. Use masking policies to partially or completely eradicate data or hash it by using the user-defined functions. Now you have a fair understanding around Redshift data masking. Now let's move to AWS Glue Data Quality. We have announced the preview of AWS Glue Data Quality, a new Glue feature that automatically measures, monitors, and manages data quality in your data lake and data pipeline. AWS Glue Data Quality reduces manual data analysis and rule identification effort from days to hours. It eliminates the manual data statical analysis, rule writing, code developments, and ongoing manual monitoring that is hallmark for data quality strugglers today. With AWS Glue Data Quality, a data engineer can select a data set from the Glue Data Catalog and request data quality rule recommendation. Glue automatically computes data statics like minimum, maximum, and correlations. Then it uses this statics to recommend a set of data quality rules specific for that data set to check the data freshness, accuracy, and integrity. This alone reduces the manual work of data quality as much as by 70%. After you get the recommendation, you can tweak them using out-of-box data quality rules and associate out-of-box action to take when data quality deteriorates. Let's learn more about data quality. At first, there is no infrastructure to maintain. You don't need to worry about scalability because AWS Glue Data Quality uses the serverless infrastructure that's run over 8,000K jobs a day. You get the benefits of auto-scaling out of box. AWS Glue Data Quality is empowered by DQ, tested at scale by Amazon teams to manage data qualities of 60 petabyte data lakes. A challenge we talk about, data engineers and data stewards need to manually profile the data. With the AWS Glue data quality, you can get your rules recommendation back to you in minutes instead of manually creating them. After you get the recommendations, you can tweak them using out-of-box data quality rules and associate out-of-box actions to take when data quality deteriorates. It is really hard to write data quality rules because most of them are in proprietary language. To solve this, we created DQDL, Data Quality Definition Language. This is a declarative open language that allows users to simplify rule authoring, promote reuse across data sets, and easy to deploy to higher environment. Like we did before, many tools either focus on DQ at rest or DQ in the data pipeline. We told us that your requirements are to have them in your workflow. So we made Glue Data Quality in a way where you can set up anywhere in your data integrations workflow. Finally, we know that data engineer and data stewards care equally about data quality. So we placed data quality on their workflow and created user experience that appeals for them. For example, data stewards can work on the data catalog without worrying about the complexity of the data pipeline or AWS Glue job, whereas the data engineer can easily integrate DQ in their pipeline with the familiar APIs. Let's learn about how it's work. If you're a data steward or a data engineer, you can go to AWS Glue Data Catalog, select a data set, and then click on AWS Glue Data Quality. You can then click on Recommendations button. And once you do this, it can provide you starting points for you to work on. You can add new rule, modify existing ones, and delete the one you don't want to. Then you can save this rule and execute them. You can view the result in the data quality results page. Data engineers uses AWS Glue Studio to build their pipelines. Now, if you are a data engineer who create visual jobs, you can add a evaluate data quality transform in your data pipeline. You can add data quality rules and associate actions. For instance, you may want to stop the job the moment you did encounter a bad record. Then you just run your pipeline. The data quality metrics are stored in a data quality tab, you have the option to write data quality results to S3 and then query them. Data engineers, IT professionals, and line of business analysts all have a part to play in the process of moving data and preparing it for analysis. The skills span the range of from Visual Studio to SQL to Scala. Now let's move to Amazon Athena. Amazon Athena makes it easy to do an interactive analytics. It is built on open source framework. It is serverless, supports broad set of file format and transactional data lake formats and other data sources through federated queries. With Athena, there is no servers to manage and no minimal fee or setup cost. You can only pay the query you run. In Athena, we have announced general availability of Amazon Athena for Apache Spark, a new Athena feature that enables you to run Apache Spark interactive analytics quicker than ever before, without the need to plan for, configure, and manage resources. With Amazon Athena for Apache Spark, interactive Spark applications start under a second and run faster with our optimized Spark runtime, so you spend more time on the inside, not waiting for results. Athena enables you to build Apache Spark application using the expressiveness of Python with the simplified notebook experience in Athena console or through Athena API. Athena is deeply integrated with other AWS services, enable you to query data from various sources, chain multiple calculations together, and visualize the result for your analysis. Now let's move to the next announcements. To make most of your data, you need a 360 degree view of your business, and you can only do that if you can see all your data across multiple business units. This is why we have built Amazon Data Zone, a fully integrated data management service that empowers everyone in organizations to make data-driven decisions at scale across business units. With the Data Zone, you get a fully business data catalog where users can search and request access to data they need for their analysis. Customer can add data assets such as data sets, database table, etc. to the catalog easily using a simple web-based interface where they can collaborate together on a data project. And all of this is done securely and governed way so that data is only accessible by the people and the system that need access, and only them able to perform the analysis. Amazon Data Zone enable customers to discover and share data scale across organization boundaries within a built-in governance and access control, removing undifferentiated heavy lifting of making data and analytics tools accessible to everyone in the organization. Amazon Data Zone improves operational efficiency for your business and a data team to work with data faster, gain insight, and make informed decisions rooted in the truth that is your data. With Amazon Data Zone, anyone in your organization can discover new and exciting realm of data from a personalized web application without expertise of underlying AWS services. Data Zone is driven by data producers, that is data engineers, data scientists, etc., who share data securely with the other right businesses context with other in the organization. And the data consumer, that is data analyst, etc., who can find answer to the business questions from the data. Then it's shared with the others in the organization. This workflow allows customers to create a decentralized and federated ownership model for the data productions and the data consumptions, often referred as a data mesh, where the data producer publish, own, and govern their data asset by setting up publishing agreements with the data stewards. The data consumer then access the data they are interested in after completing the approval workflow with the data owners. Hope you have liked all these new announcements and super excited to try them out. This is the end of my presentations. Thank you.